Hello, my name is Kim, professor of Kalasangam University, India. Today's topic is 7th G transform. Here, how do we know causality of, from H of G and stability from H of G? For the stable and unstable system in time domain H of N, I have explained already my lecture number 11. You need to know more detail, you can refer my lecture number 11. This stable meaning is when bounded input comes to this system, and from this we can get, if we get bounded output, then we call this stable system. Here, bounded, here input, bounded output. Here, bounded means summation of input. Summation signal is less than infinite. Same as like this. We call this bounded input, bounded output. Sometimes we call this bounded input, bounded output also is this one. For example, in this case, input signal is this, 0, 0, 0. This means bounded input signal. And from this, if we get this, and 0, this one. Then this is bounded output. From this, we can, this system is a stable system. Now like this, bounded input comes to here. If we get bounded output, then we call this stable system. Like this, by bounded input output stable criterion is all summation of impulse response is less than infinite. We call this variable input, bounded up input, bounded output stability criterion. From this, I would like to explain stable systems from H of N. From this, I would like to derive to H of G. Now in time domain, this kind of system, A to the power N, UN. UN is unit function. And this A is here. In order for this not to go to infinite, we need this condition. This is the condition for stability in time domain. It's a very important concept. And from this, we can derive the condition, stability condition in G domain. Now here, this, we can transform like this. For this, you can transfer my lecture number 19 here. Okay, then we can get 1 minus 1 minus AG minus 1, and ROCG is greater than A like this. Now here, point is very important. Pole is A. Now here, this means this. This is some meaning of poles. It's very important concept. Also, in order for H of N not to go to infinity means ROC is exterior of this. Okay, like this. Now here the exterior. All things exterior of this ROC. Now, this is exterior. And also we need one condition from this. This means A is less than 1. 1 means the circle whose radius is equal to 1, like this. Radius equal 1, equal this 1. Therefore, A less than 1 means this pole should be inside in the circle whose radius is equal to 1. Therefore, for stable system, all poles should be inside of the circle whose radius is equal to 1, this one. Yes. Now, this one. Okay? Inside of the circle, whose radius is equal to 1. Then, the exercise. First, yn equal x of n plus this one. And first, we transform y of n to y of g equal x of g plus 0.1. This means g to the power minus 1 y of g. This is the one delay component. Delay component. From this, y of g by x of g equals transformation h of g equal 1 by 1 minus 0.1 g to the power minus 1. Okay. Then, 4 equal, that is 4 equal, 4 equal g equal 0.1. Therefore, the 4 is, the 4 is 0.1 here. This means the unit circle is, this means unit circle is here. Therefore, 4 lies in the unit circle whose radius is 1. Therefore, this is stable sheet. Okay? Next, this one. Y of n, and like this, we transform y of n to y of g equal x of g minus this one also g to the power of minus 1 0.5 g to the power of minus 1 y of g plus g to the power of minus 2 y of g. And from this, y of g by x of g equals h of g equals here 1 by 1 plus 0.5 g to the power minus 1 minus g to the minus 2 equals, can make them the factorizing 1 minus 0.5 g to the power minus 1 and 1 plus 2 g to the power minus 1. From this, we can get the 4 points. This from this 4 g equal 0.5. From this, 4 g equal minus 2. Then, in G plane here, 4 is 0.5 and minus 2 is here. And the unit circle, it is 1. Therefore, this 4 is outside the unit circle. Therefore, this is an unstable system. Unstable, okay? Then next, causality of the system from h of g. And also, for the causal non-causal system in time domain h of n, I already explained in my lecture 8, here, causal non-causal systems. If you want more detail, please refer my lecture number 8. Okay, the causal system also, let me explain from the h of n and h of g. Causal system means like this. H of n equals 0 for all n is less than 1. This means right side signal. All left, this is left. Left signal is all 0, just the right side signal. We call this causal system. For example, this kind of one. This is the right side signal. Right side signal. This kind is a causal system. Then, from this, we can derive the condition of the causality in G domain also. Now, as we know already, right side signal means ROC is exterior of the circle, outside the outmost pole in G plane. This. Okay? This is the condition for the causal in G domain. This is exterior of the circle, RC exterior circle, whose radius is equal to A. And we call this causal system. For example, y of n equal 2 to the power n u n. Okay. From this, of course, we know already in time domain, this means unit function, that this is a right side signal. Therefore, this is a causal system. You know already. Also, we want to examine from the G domain. Therefore, from this, we can convert G domain, then y over g equal, from definition of g domain, n equal minus infinite 2 to the power of n, u over n, g to the power minus n. Means, because of this, this means n equal 0 to infinite 2 to the power of n, g to the power minus n. Equal, as you know already, 1 by 1 minus 2, g to the power minus n, minus 1. Okay? Then also here, g is greater than 2. Therefore, this is 2, circle g here. The greater than means outside, external. Therefore, this is causal system. Causal system, you can say. Okay, next, next problem, now here, y of n equal 2 to the power n, u n plus 1. Also, y of g, transform y of g equal summation n equal minus infinite 2 to the power n, u n plus 1. Okay, now here, now, this means n equal minus 1, 0, 1, 2, like this, go to infinite. Therefore, we can divide two parts. We can divide this part and all this part. Then, equal, first of all, n equal minus 1, means 2 to the power minus n, u, n equal minus n plus 1. Plus, this part is summation n equal minus n equal 0 to infinite 2 to the power of r1, g to the power minus n. Okay, now here we need g. Now here we need g to the power of minus 1 is here. Okay, let me explain one more time. Okay. Okay, now here, into g to the power minus minus 1, plus infinite n equal 0 to infinite 2 to the power of n, g to the power minus n, equal, n equal 1 is here, therefore 0.5, this is 1, therefore g to the power of 1, plus, this means, already we know, 1 plus 2 g to the power minus 1. Okay. Then, pole point. Where is the pole point? From this, pole equal infinite. From this, pole equal minus 2. Therefore, this is the outermost pole. Okay, this is outermost pole. Therefore, ROC, G is greater than infinite. Then this is impossible. Therefore, we call this non-causal system. Okay. Today, thank you so much for your watching. Today, I explained the stability in G domain and the causality in G domain. Next topic, let me explain the Fourier transform. Maybe this is more than 15 lectures. More than 15 lectures. I'm not sure. Please look forward to next lecture. Thank you very much.